Yo's gonna be
the fabricator draws from available data to provide environment appropriate equipment using locally available materials. For your safety, this setting cannot be overridden. The seed will increase your effective exploration range. For your safety, please pack supplies for long journeys and stay within 5 kilometers of the nearest life pod or habitat. The builder tool is designed to construct habitats capable of withstanding extreme environmental conditions. Weapons were removed from standard survival blueprints following the massacre on Abraxas Prime. The knife remains the only exception. Motivational note. Craig McGill crash-landed in the acid swamps of Boreal 9, fought off arachnid kidney poachers, and hijacked a Tay Star Wars. If he can do all that, you can survive one more day. The Aurora suffered orbital hull failure. Cause unknown. 0 human life signs detected.
Like I was trying to say while that lady talked over me, we're playing Subnautica, we're the only creative. Why? Because I want to build the dumbest things that this game offers. So, here's my habitat builder. Yes, alright. I'm actually just building my base.
It may be prudent to separate work and leisure spaces to maximize productivity. Treat this space as your home, but never forget that it is not. After weeks without human contact, it is normal to experience psychological discomfort. Research indicates symptoms may be partly alleviated by adopting a pet or anthropomorphizing an inanimate object.
They're connected, but why wouldn't the moon pool connect? I told you, I'm just gonna build the stupidest thing in this entire fucking game.
Unless constructed with a specific research task in mind, observatories and other glass modules are imprudent for survival purposes.
Let me disconnect this. I'm gonna try and build it. See, they changed this, so now you can't just like build anywhere. Guess I'm not gonna be build one of those, huh?
Power restored. All primary systems online. Remember, it's like a straight line. Which now I'm gonna drop away from.
This is Life Pod 6. I have a passenger on board. Coordinates attached. We've landed a kilometer from the crash site, but there's radiation in between us and the rendezvous. Request immediate assistance. 6 out.
There's no more room. That's all I need. It's a mess. I'm gonna build a nuclear reactor. So yeah, I do need a reactor now, which looks okay. That's cool. sell anything, it's gotta help. And it's a purple and orange equipped thing. Yeah, I do need puppies. It's all just equipment and tools, scanner, necessary.
Like, the scanner can be used to synthesize blueprints from salvage technology and to record alien biological data.
Flashlight, I got dive reel. Don't see need for that either. I have that laser cut. Let's see, stasis, we're gonna make stuff. Don't blame me. Yes, do me a beacon. Beakers are good too. I'll go like four. Third one that's counting wrong. And I think that's all we can do.
Detecting increased local radiation levels. Trend is consistent with damage to the Aurora's drive core, sustained during planet fall.
I'm driving there, but I'm not. I don't. It's already daytime. So it's definitely this one. is the way this was the way the entire time. I just need to bring one of the street line. Another being about 100 meters away from the base.
Self-scan complete. Vital signs normal. Detecting trace amounts of foreign bacteria. Continuing to monitor.
Traveling down to 1.6.
Scans show a nearby cave entrance, depth 90 meters, leading to an unknown environmental biome. Short-range scans suggest this biome supports extensive biodiversity and connects to a number of small cave networks. Integrating new PDA data. Thank you.
this. I'm supposed to be seeing ground, but there's nothing. That there's something. Alright, everything just popped back into existence. Okay. Maybe I shouldn't be playing this. This just turned into a horror game. Lands, like.
Detecting massive energy signature in the region. Cannot identify.
Shut up, CPU. In the ground, aren't I? I'm in a cave. And these sounds are weird. There are some like weird like clicking. Someday.
Warning, entering ecological dead zone. Adding report to databank.
Crater Edge. Just forgot. Geological. Geological schemes of disappear show a steep decline in all directions. This data is consistent with the theory that the aurora crashed on the edge of a 2 kilometer by 2 kilometer volcanic crater. It has likely been millennia since the eruption reached the surface, encouraging the ecosystem within the crater to flourish. Ecology of the trench surrounding the crater supports only two kinds of life, microscopic and leviathan class. Exploration is ill-advised. Yeah. That's a ghost leviathan that's broken. There's a broken. We're going back here. That's a warper. Where are we? There you are, buddy. See, I'm still creeped out by, like, giant creatures. And then there's normal one. Wait, where are we right now? Because being normal is fun by the items. Unless I'm also like really close to the spaghetti. Why is there a giant rock look? Not joking, this. Really creepy. That's scary because it just pops into existence. These grounds will look great now. Yeah. And now we're going down again. we're back at the port. Pretty sure we're back at the port. Any light, unless it's like nighttime right now. I see surface, I think. I've seen something. I've seen a thing. I've seen Mars.
Detecting volcanic activity and several unusual electromagnetic signatures in the region. Exercise caution when diving deeper.
Also, now you tell me.
Continued degradation of the Aurora's drive core may result in a quantum detonation. Continuing to monitor.
And I'm on the outside.